Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, my darling. And many, many more. Another year had passed. I love you. Your eyes I love to see, your hands I love to touch, your lips I love to kiss, I love you all so very much. Tomorrow start a new year, and memories couldn't wait. I want to say I love you, darling, happy. Health, God bless you. That's all my heart can say. Good luck, good health, God bless you and keep you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Today is your natal day, my darling. It's a very special day for me, too. For anything that's part of you, I hold it dearly, my darling. I want me this day put into use my finest and sincerest memory. How do I greet thee? Shall I reach you the same way others do? Sending cards, flowers and music, or presents of diamonds and pearls, to express this day's feelings. But my love, I shall keep in silence. Hear me. Happy birthday, my darling, on this very special day. Happy birthday, my darling.
Thank you. So happy birthday, dear heartache. Same time, same place next year. So happy birthday, dear heartache. Same time, same place next year.
I've done a lot of stories in my time, but never one like this. It's about a woman who found frogs in her toilet, and she didn't want to open her toilet seat because she was afraid another frog would jump out. Ms. Lacey, when is the last time that you opened the lid to your toilet seat?
Mr. Zindler, I opened the lid on last Tuesday after I had noticed a frog in the john jumping up and down. But prior to that time, I had discovered a frog on the bedroom floor on a Saturday night while talking on the telephone.
Well, when did you really finally open up and find out they came out of your toilet?
When I saw the frog jumping up and down about a week ago. I had come in to use the toilet. When I was in position, I saw this object jumping up and down. I panicked. Only that time I got enough courage to reach over and flush the john. The frog went down. About 2 hours later, I could hear a thumping sound against the lid, so I knew that he was not gone.
That's when you became scared and didn't open the lid again.
That is correct.
And you haven't opened the lid since last Tuesday.
That's right, when I reported to the city that the frogs existed.
Did they think you were lying or dreaming of this?
No, they sent a representative out to check the line and indicated to me that it was a private problem. When I called the mayor's office, the administrative assistant asked me if I had a fishing net. That was about the best thing to use in order to get the fish from the toilet.
You mean the frog?
The frog from the bowl. So, knowing that I had no other alternative, I thanked him for his time.
Are these, what kind of frogs are these?
All I know is a toad frog. I'm not familiar with
little toad frogs. Little toad frogs about this big. They're not the big ones with the big legs that jump around out in the water.
Not the type that I like to eat.
Well, here it is Tuesday night, a week later, and my cameraman is standing in the bathtub, Bob Dowse. I've got the box. You're going to open up that lid, and we're going to find out if there's any more frogs in that toilet, okay?
Yes.
So let's open up the lid. Well, if there was a frog in this toilet now, he's hiding. Let's see. Well, I'll tell you what. There's no frogs in there now. Where do you go to the bathroom?
I have another bathroom, fortunately, and I use that one when necessary.
Oh, I guess I wouldn't want to sit on that toilet seat either, having a frog jumping up every once in a while.
You know, it's really no laughing matter. You know, you can look at me all you want with those big froggy eyes, but I still don't want you little creatures in my commode. You know, I guess you may wonder how those toads get into your john. Well, in this case, they came up through the sewer system, and when plumbers checked out the line, they found five. That's right, five little Kermit lookalikes. What about the advice some city hall employee gave Ms. Lacey on how to get rid of her problem? Well, it's just another stupid bureaucratic answer. Marvin Zindler, Eyewitness News.